Ice's Biggest Plate started in 2011, and my collaborator Rita Ikonen from Finland and I, we both lived in England, but we didn't know each other. But she sent me an email, and she had been googling three words in Google. One was photographer, grannies, and Norway. So my name showed up as the top result because I had just done a photography book about Norwegian older women. And she wanted to collaborate because she's working a lot with photographers to collaborate, and she works with sculpture a lot. So she asked if I wanted to come and join for a project in Norway. So then we had never met, and we were supposed to share a flat in Sandnes, which is on the southwestern coast of Norway, for 1.5 months. So it was really lucky that we got along so well. And in the beginning, the idea was to look at the personifications of nature, how back in the day, how people would explain natural phenomenons. And we looked at Nordic folk tales and some characters from specific Norwegian folk tales. Well, I had been working with grandpas and grandmas before and found that particular group to be very fascinating and more exciting to talk to. Also, since in the beginning, we were wondering what kind of status folk tales has today. And we thought perhaps the older generation would be closer to the history and having experience more than maybe younger people, then they have more stories to share. So that's why we started with them. And also they have proven to be very exciting to work with, and they are a lot of fun. We traveled to quite a few countries. So total countries now, I think 12, and over 60 people. And as we started to travel and cross borders, people's relationship to nature also changed a lot. And from the beginning, our focus also changed from specific folk tales to more how is the personal relationship to your surroundings? How do you relate to nature? Do you find it pragmatic? Do you go to the forest to chop the wood to use for a house, or could it be something else? What happens with your imagination, sense of imagination? So it has kind of evolved a little bit into how modern human belong in nature. The mission of this project too is to try to get all kinds of generations to think a little bit more about what kind of relationship you have with your environment, and maybe open the eyes a little bit to see that we are maybe not so distant from it, that we are nature as well. Sometimes we see a fabulous looking person on the street, and we just go over and say, "Hello, can we talk to you?" Or sometimes some grandmother or a friend wants to take part, but every time we have to get to know this person in order to figure out what kind of material, what kind of sculpture can we make together. So it all depends on each person's story, where they live, where maybe they have a special place in the nature they like to go to. Maybe they go and harvest a particular herb that they use for decoration or for eating or medicine. Maybe they long for a place, and we go to that place where they haven't been before. And at the scenery, we see the material that is there and maybe think about, ah, this person is like has this and this personality. And then together we pick the materials, and we start to think, okay, this image could look like this. And then it is put together, maybe hopefully if we have time, the day before. Sometimes it's on the day, so it's very kind of rushed. And then we go into the nature and put it all together. And that whole process takes maybe a day. So we get to know the person quite intimate in a very short amount of time. 6 years of production, and it was an epic journey to get this book off the ground, but it's fantastic to see it's finally here.
Ta-da!
We have been thinking a long time, how should we gather the whole material? Because it's a lot of material, it's many years, and there's a lot of stories, and it's very important for us to show the process behind this project. It's equally important as the final results. So we have over 60 older people. Each of them has a specific story, how we got to know, the reasons why we chose the sculpture, the place they are being photographed, and we wanted to share this in the book. So it's the structure of it is each has got a text and a final photo, and you can see that as individual pieces. But half of the book is also behind the scenes of showing the process, how we all met, where we found the material, the natural materials, and it was important to show, to reveal the process because it's such an important part of the project. The publisher of the book is Press Publishing. They are a Norwegian independent publisher, which I worked with on my previous book and will work with next. They are friendly, small, independent. The cover of each book or every single book is unique. So Rita and I, we have been gluing leaves so on each side of the cover, 8,000 leaves. And then it has been also, they are kind of veiled under the cover cloth. And then we had a little accident, or the bookbinder had a little accident in the final process. So we thought we were finished, and we got this phone call from our publisher who said that I have some distressing news. The cover of the book is smaller than the content, the inside of the book. So we had to do it again. So we have been gluing 16,000 leaves all in total, but at least now every book is very special with a lot of love. We have promised each other to continue as long as it's fun, and it's still a lot of fun, and we will continue to exhibit and travel. So we will go back to Greenland this autumn, and we've just photographed my grandparents in my home city in Trondheim, Norway, and we will continue where chance takes us. We have actually already started to collect new work for maybe a second edition of a book. And since we have already glued 8,000 extra covers, the outside of the book is ready, waiting. So I think we would love to do a second edition if the project continues. So yes, that's the goal.